Hello, dear students. Today we learn about the five kingdom system of classification or five kingdom classification. It was given by Whitaker. Whitaker in 1969. It was given by Robert H. Whitaker in 1969. First, it was two kingdom system of classification, which was put forth by Aristotle. That means only plants and animals. All organisms on the earth, they were categorized either into plants or animals. Then another scientist came, Ernest Haeckel came. He recognized some unicellular organisms from these plants and animals, and created the third kingdom, then fourth. And Robert H. Whitaker, 1969, he classified all organisms, all animal or plants on the earth, all organisms. They classify this man, Whitaker, classified these organisms into five kingdoms. And these five kingdoms are number one, and there are some criteria to divide these all organisms into different groups, into different kingdoms. And these criteria or these characters, which are very important to distinguish between the five kingdoms, like this. Number one is all organisms are either prokaryotes or eukaryotes. That means having prokaryotes, primitive nucleus, and eukaryote. All organisms. First, all organisms are categorized into two major kingdoms, or you can say domains. That means prokaryota, or you can say prokaryota, prokaryota. That means domain, or you can say super kingdom. Eukaryota, eukaryota. All organisms are categorized into two domains, prokaryota and eukaryota, based upon the cell structure, either primitive cell or the modern cell, or you can say advanced cell having advanced nucleus. Then now the prokaryotes having primitive nucleus. Prokaryote, the only one kingdom which comes under the domain of prokaryota, that is Monera, kingdom Monera. It is kingdom Monera, the first kingdom, kingdom Monera. Then the eukaryotes, the eukaryotes are other all organisms. They can be either multicellular or unicellular. The unicellular character includes the another kingdom, that is the kingdom number two, that is protista. That means it is the protista is a eukaryote, unicellular. What is the difference between protista and monera? Simple one character. Protista are eukaryotes, and prokaryote, these monera are prokaryotes. Now the multicellular or the rest organisms, they come under multicellular heading. The multicellular can either have cell wall, that means multicellular organisms can have either cell wall, or the cell wall is absent or without cell wall. It is another criteria. Presence of cell wall or absence of cell wall. Some organisms have cell wall, and those organisms which are having cell wall again divided into two subcategories, these groups. And the another criteria, another feature of organisms having cell wall is either they are a photosynthetic, that means they do not perform photosynthesis. They are not performing photosynthesis, that means they cannot prepare their own food. And another group is photosynthetic, those organisms which prepare their own food. That means they are having common characteristic, that means cell wall. Next is which organisms are photosynthetic, that means which do not can perform photosynthesis but must have cell wall. The two characters. They do not perform photosynthesis but must have cell wall. And the third kingdom comes, that is किंगडम थर्ड फंजे, दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज नॉन ग्रेन प्लांट्स, नॉन ग्रेन प्लांट्स बिकॉज दे आर नॉट ग्रेन इन कलर एंड दे डू नॉट परफॉर्म फोटोसिंथेसिस. देन अनदर किंगडम दैट इज विच इज फोटोसिंथेटिक, दैट मीन्स कैन प्रिपेयर देयर ओन फूड एंड दे हैव सेल वॉल, दैट मीन्स दे आर प्लांट्स, ऑल ग्रीन प्लांट्स. दीज फोटोसिंथेटिक, दैट मीन्स ऑल ग्रीन प्लांट्स परफॉर्म फोटोसिंथेसिस एंड हैव सेल वॉल. ऑल फंजी आर नॉन फोटोसिंथेटिक, they are not green and have cell wall. That means what is the characteristic, common characteristic between plants and plant and fungi? One characteristic is common, that means they are having with cell wall and are eukaryotes. Both are eukaryotes and both are having cell wall. What is the difference? They do not perform photosynthesis, they perform photosynthesis. And another is multicellular, under the heading of multicellular, another is without cell wall. Those organisms which are not having cell wall. And this is the another kingdom. It is kingdom 4 and it is kingdom 5. Animalia, animals. These are the organisms which do not have cell wall but are multicellular. That means animalia. All animals come under this category. All multicellular animals. Examples in protista, examples are amoeba is there, paramecium is there. Monera includes all bacteria. This is the five kingdom system of classification having five kingdoms: kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, kingdom Fungi, kingdom Plantae and kingdom Animalia. These five kingdoms, on the basis of this table, you can differentiate on the basis of one or two characters between them. And further, we have to study them, we have to read one by one these kingdoms and their characters with examples. Five kingdom system of classification having one drawback, that it cannot include viruses. That means viruses are not included in this because virus is not formed of a cell. It was today's lesson, and we will take these kingdoms one by one in next lesson. Thank you.